AWS allows you to implement custom runtimes for your Lambda functions, which means that you can run your C, C++, Rust code, or maybe use Deno or other things that are currently not supported by AWS. A custom runtime is a simple piece of code that starts when the Lambda is created, fetches the request information, executes the request, sends the response back, and it starts over waiting for another request. These operations will use the runtime APIs that you can find at the host specified in the AWS Runtime API environment variable. The first API waits for the next request or event and returns a request ID that you can find in the headers and a body containing a JSON with the specific event data. For example, the application load balancer has only a few fields with the HTTP method, the path, query params, and the body. The API gateway has a different structure, but you can find the method, path, query params, and body along many other information. If the trigger of the function is SQS, you can receive a batch of messages, and each message has its own body, attributes, and more. Once we have the request or the event, we can execute our handler, the one that has the logic that we want to execute on the Lambda. With the result, we can now send back the response, and again, we use the runtime API to notify a success or a failure. The basic code to implement the runtime should look like this. We get the runtime API host from the environment variables, we do an HTTP GET to fetch the next event, we execute the handler code, we send back the response, and we keep doing it forever. AWS will take care of killing the process when best. These operations are really simple, and you can even implement that using a bash script. Now that our runtime code is ready, we are going to create a container image. If you want to create a Deno runtime, we can create an image with the Deno binary executable, the Lambda runtime source that we just wrote, and the Lambda handler code. We also need a bootstrap script that will be our entry point. We can pack everything together using Docker, and it will be simple as adding our files. If you want to use Deno, another approach is to use the Deno compile command to build a self-contained executable. In this way, the Docker file will just contain the executable. This last method is valid for everything that produces a binary executable. So if you have something written in Rust or in C or in C++, you can use the same method of building the binary and adding it to the entry point of your container. You can use GraalVM native images to convert your Java code into a binary executable. There are plugins for Maven and Gradle to simplify your build process, and once you have the binary, you can add it to the container. You can push your container to ACR, the Elastic Container Registry, and create a new Lambda using the container image. Remember that if you want to use the Graviton processor, you have to build your binary for that architecture. And remember that Amazon Linux 2 has a different libc version from the Amazon Linux 2023. Check the links in the description below to find the Deno binary for the Graviton processor and the runtime examples. If you are interested in this kind of content and want to see more, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any question or want to know more, leave a comment below.